Good morning, class.
Good morning, ma'am.
How are you today?
We're fine, ma'am.
Okay. So before we are going to start with our lesson, do you want to sing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let's sing a song that I have composed it for you, and we will adapt it to the tune of Top of the World. Do you know the song?
Yes, ma'am.
So let's sing it all together. Okay? Everybody stand.
Moving object.
Okay. So when I say go, you are going to raise your answer. Yes? Okay. So are you ready? Raise your answers. For group 1, Fa. For group 2, it's Fa. And for group 3, it's Fa. And let's see the answer. Okay, it's Fa. So you all deserve a round of applause. Okay. Question number 2. Will you read group 2?
Force can change the speed of a moving object.
Okay. Go. Okay, for group 1, we have love. For group 2, we have fat. And for group 3, we have fat. Okay, we see the answer? It's a fat. So only group 2 and group 3 got the answer. And they deserve a?
Wow!
Okay, look at my hand signals. Yes. Next. Will you read group 3?
By applying force to the brake, the vehicle will continue to move.
Okay. Raise your answers. Love, love, and block. Okay, and the answer is, it's a block. Okay, so everybody again got the correct answer, and it's?
Awesome!
Okay, next. Will you read again, group 1?
Gravity is a force that pulls all objects toward the surface.
Okay, answer? Fuck, fuck, and fuck. Okay, so let's ask the answer. It's again a fuck. And you all deserve a. Next. Group 2, will you read?
Friction is a force that does not slow down or stop motion.
Okay. Answer. Block, block, and block. And the answer is, it's a block. Okay. So who got the most correct answers? It's group 2 and 3. Okay. I will give you a star in your group. Okay, so you deserve this star, and for group 3, you deserve a yellow star. Okay, so now, please go back now to your proper places. Can you do again another activity? Yes? I will group you into two only. Yes? So from this group, this will be group 1, and for this one, this will be group 2. Okay, go. Okay. So we will do another activity. Here are envelopes. Inside it are jumbled letters. Now, I want you to assemble these jumbled letters and paste it on the cartolina. And whoever finishes it first, you clap your hands and post your work in the board. Okay, so I will name this group. What group is this? This will be the Warriors group. And this will be also the Raptors group. Okay, so you may stay there at the center. I'll to assemble the words. And for the Raptors group, you may stay there. Okay, go. I have nobody there. Leader, leader. Okay. And leader here. I will give you a clue. Okay, this is your glove, and this is your glove. Okay, you may open up the envelope, okay, and you may start now. I think you are fitted there. What's the jumbled letters inside of the envelope? That's what we're going to assemble. If you have to know, you cut your head, you use the penis first. Don't get too close with one another. Last 1 minute. Can you put silver on the board with the meaning and get the meaning also? And get ready for the leader to present what have you got, what have you found, what word have you assembled, yes? Are you ready, Raptors group?
Yes.
May I call on now the leader to him and present to us what have you found inside the envelope? What word are you going to form out of the jumbled words?
morning, ma'am. Good morning, classmates. This is the output of group raptors. A force that pulls objects toward one another is the gravitational force.
Yes, very good. May we give raptors group a Unisha clap? Ready, go!
Very good, very good, very good.
Now, may we welcome also the leader of the warriors group to report.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, classmates. This is the output of team of warriors. As our forces that opposes motion between two surfaces touching each other is frictional force.
Okay. They also deserve a dhamma clap. May we give them a dhamma clap? Ready, go! Ihan pa to?
Dhamma!
Okay. Now, so you found out about frictional force and gravitational force. Do you know about it, children? Yes or no? Okay, it says here that frictional force are forces that opposes motion between two surfaces touching at its other. Yes? While gravitational force is a force that pulls objects toward one another. Now, I have here a picture of the solar system. See? Can you see that at the back?
Yes.
Okay. So this is a picture of the solar system. With the sun as the center of the solar system and the eight planets revolving around it. Now, what do you think is the reason why the planets do not bump at each other while they revolve around the sun? Yes, any idea, Aaron?
Because of gravity.
Because of gravity. Whose gravity is it? Yes, Nicole.
The sun's
gravity. How about the planets? Do they have gravity too?
Yes,
yes. Like the Earth and the eight planets, they too have gravity, which maintain their distances from each other, which pulls them towards another, and they do not bump at each other, and they are not drawn towards the sun because of gravity. Okay, so in here it says that gravity is a force that pulls all objects in the universe towards one another, and it is the force which pulls all objects on the surface of the Earth. Where can you find gravity? Under the ground or on the surface of the Earth. Okay, now I have here a toy car. I have a volunteer to operate the toy car. Yes, someone is raising his hand there. Aaron, come here and operate the toy car. So what if, have you experienced riding a car?
Yes, ma'am.
Going to Baguio?
Yes, ma'am.
Going to some higher places? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now let us see how this car is going to have a trip on a steep and winding road. Yes? You may start. Let's pretend that it's climbing on a mountain. This car will be climbing on a mountain. Okay? Start now for a road. Yes. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry it's tumbled down. But as you can see, thank you. As the car will climb up a mountain or a hill, what will happen to its speed? Will it slow down or get fast?
Slow down.
Why? Why does the car slow its motion in going up on a hill or a rocky road or a rough road? Why? What must be the force that is acting on the car between the tires and the road?
Friction.
Yes, it's all about friction. Okay. So what is about friction, children? Will you, anyone can read it? Rihanna.
Friction is a force that acts against or stops motion when two surfaces rub against each other.
Yes, when two surfaces rub against each other or acts against each other, it may stop motion or slow down a motion like that with our car a while ago. Okay, now we will do another activity. Do you want more activity?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So for the Warriors group, I will give you a toy car. Yes. And here are here is a doormat. May I have now my toy car? Okay, so you may use this one or this toy car here. Now, here is a doormat. Let's pretend that this will represent a
rat.
What is the texture of this doormat?
Rough.
So this may represent a rough road. Okay, and here is your toy car. Yes, you are going to let the toy car run on the smooth area. And it will pass through this rocky or this rough surface. Yes? I have the leader to grab it now, the materials. Have three volunteers to perform the activity later on in this group. And then for the group of Raptors group, I have here a coin bank, a cotton, and I have here also a wood here.
Me.
So what are you going to do for group Raptors? You are going to drop these objects at the same height at the same time. Yes? What can you say about these objects? Are they heavy or light?
Light.
Light.
Light. Do they have the same weight?
No.
Okay. Now we are going to have three volunteers to drop this at the same time, at the same height. And please take note of your observations. Yes? Okay, we have the leader now. Assign members to do the activity. And report your output later on. Okay? I will give you again 2 minutes to do it. You may start now. Okay, go. Yes, you may do it here, and the other one, you may do it here. Stay on the side of the aisle only so that you can see how the car will move. The what will perform will stay here. Who will perform first? You will stay here. Ito mag-start yung car, pagano siya. And record your observations. Okay, Aaron will do it first. Observe what will happen to the car as it passes through the rough road. Okay. The next one to perform. Then Michael. Again. Then another try. Another one. It should pass through the rough road. Okay. Then you have also here another one. Let's pretend this is a grassy area. Okay? So place it there. Okay. What happened? Okay, you record your observations. Okay, next, four group, raptors, let us see also. How they are going to perform. Okay, so you have there your katan, your coin bank, and the wood. They are of different weights. Now, instruction is you are going to drop those objects at the same time and record your observations. Okay? Are you ready? At the count of three, drop ninyo. Okay, at the count of... Zaina, it's not leveled with the wood. Okay, are you ready? Ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, may we have another try? Three pupils again. Not three anymore. Okay? At the same height also, ah? Dapat sabay-sabay. Kasi nahuli kami na yung coin bank. Okay, ready? Are you ready? At the count of three. Make it higher. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, another try. Last group. Try, yes. Go. Okay, ready. 1, 2, 3. Okay, you may pick up now the objects and go back to your seat.
Slow down yung wood.
Okay. So, it is, they found out that it's gravity that pulls down the objects to the surface. They all fell to the ground. Okay. So, except for a resistance, children, like those of the feather, according to Sir Isaac Newton, he found out that all objects have the same speed when falling to the ground at 9.8 meters per second, except for the feather, he was air resistance. Okay, so they all fall to the ground at the same time, regardless of weight and speed. Okay, so that is the gravitational force or gravitational pull. Okay, so this time, so do you understand now about frictional force, children, and gravitational force?
Yes.
Okay, so this time I will play a video and you are going to listen to it very well to further enrich your understanding about frictional force and gravitational force. Okay. Okay, so now you are going to listen very well and take down notes of the important matters.
Life would be impossible without friction.
Video.
To use friction in most of our activities. You would be able to walk without slipping and falling with the help of friction. Friction affects different objects too. Without friction, you would not be able to write because your pencil would slip off the surface of the paper you are writing on. What is friction? Friction opposes motion. It causes an object that moves around the surface to slow down and eventually stop. The application of friction is illustrated if you let a coin